Yo guys, after several months, I have to install Komodo again for a friend. And you know, it's so surprising that so many things can change. The package went from 80 megabytes to 200 megabytes. Anyway, you get the selection. It's in Dutch, but don't worry, it will be the same. Up here, it wants you to connect to the DNS servers of Komodo. Please don't select that. Don't select this. And please don't select that. Up here, you click more options. You know, it wants to install a web browser for you. That while you already have a web browser, it wants to install GBody for you. No need, you know? Now, if we continue with the installation, here we can go back. So we go back to the front, you know, and up here we hit next. Then you will see that Komodo comes with spyware, people. It comes with stupid toolbars. You know, such a good virus scanner, SQ firewall, comes with, you know, rubbish. So you have to click this off. But be careful before you click this off. You know, also click this off first. Do this one first, then this one, because they did it to trick you. So, because if you just click this one off, you know, Komodo, you're disappointing me, man. Really, I was favorite of yours. You know, I want drive dog me bloody blah. Only show me trusted advertiser. Who says I want to see that bullshit advertisings? Come on, man. You know, Komodo, get the life, man. And up here, we can say then, it says okay and install, but make sure you deselected that, you know, otherwise it will install spyware on your machine. That while this thing is a firewall virus scanner. So how can a firewall virus scanner come with spyware? That while the app already knows everything that is running on your computer, because it's already sending information to Komodo. So Komodo knows each and every site, such as every other virus scanner that hides on your computer. You know, if you go to the adult sites, they know about it, man. If you're using hacked programs, they know about it. You know, so what is the use of putting spyware on people's machine? You know, no need. So I hope you saw now how to install Komodo Internet Security. The package went to 200 megabytes from a lousy 70 megabytes when, you know, I fell in love with the program. It got so fat, up to 200 megabytes, man. Yeah, and when it's installed, it's gonna even download more. It's gonna get even bigger. This thing is gonna grow at least up to 500 megabytes. Maybe, well, a gig. Maybe we don't even know how much, you know? So, whatever, it took over the firewall, so don't worry about this warning. Up here, you will read that the Windows firewall, I cannot even show it to you. There you go. The Windows firewall is whatever, you know, it's all good. You know, it's installed now. By the way, this is the Acer that we repaired the screen of. I cleaned it really nice. It looks like new, so my friend will have a brand new computer. Okay, we also see here an icon called shared spaces. You see that? We're gonna delete that one, because or you should want to use it. I don't know, maybe then you must keep it. Up here you see something popping up in the screen, you know, telling you bloody bloody blah. You go to here, you see, you open up the firewall, but you go to right mouse click, yeah, and then you go to widget, you know, and then hold on, you go to widget up here, to widget, and then you say don't show the damn widget, you see. So then it's gone. Haha, we are free of all the nonsense. Anyway, now you have a very good, at least I think that it's a very good virus scanner. It don't have to scan. This is a brand new system. You don't have to scan for nothing. So go away. It's saying in danger, in danger. And now, you know, we just installed 200 megabytes of files, but still it says it haven't been updated. So you know, I guess the files that we downloaded were not enough to protect you. So now, of course, we hit update, and now it's gonna update a file for you, probably another 146 megabyte. So that is already 350 megabyte of data that this thing is waiting. You know, I have to really look for another firewall, virus scanner, because this thing is getting too big, yo. Maybe F-Secure or so, I don't know, Bitdefender, they all got so fat. I don't know why they are so fat. What is it that makes them so fat? These firewalls and virus scanners. I really don't know. Anyway, peeps, I hope you like this video. This is still a very good virus scanner firewall if you undo all the junk and all the rubbish that comes with it. And to the developers of the owners of Komodo, I would say, you know, not a good thing to do to put fire, how you call it, these toolbars and nonsense in a great program as this. You know, find other ways to advertise, or maybe find other ways to make money, but please don't do it this way, because you're infecting people with computers that, you know, will be like zombies connected to the people that pay you guys. And I don't think that is what you want, and I think it's not fair that you give these guys permission to, you know, install these toolbars, because when another program wants to install a toolbar, the virus scanner immediately pops up and say, hey yo, bloody blah, you know, this and that toolbar, that while this toolbar, you know, you guys are delivering it, you know. So that's a real bad thing of you guys to do. Find other ways to make advertising or to make your money, because that is not a good way, you know. So yeah, that's all I wanted to say. Besides that, you guys are one of the best free firewall virus scanners to use. As you can see, I also use it here on my computer, and I use it for many, many years. So I'm not saying Komodo is not good. I'm just saying Komodo is coming with a lot of rubbish these days in the installation, and that is really sad. Really sad. Anyway, thank you for watching, people. This was Puck, and till my next video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and hit this video like. Thank you. Bye bye.